Okay.
What is going on, guys? Welcome to a brand new video. And today we're going to be doing a classic show. We're doing a classic one. I've already seen most of it. I haven't finished it fully, but it's been some years since I've watched this show. And obviously you can see in the title, Freaks and Geeks. So yes, I have seen the show, but it has been quite some time. And I just wanted to do like a throwback thing, like throwback Wednesdays. You know, we'll have Obi-Wan, Miss Marvel, and Freaks and Geeks. What a Wednesday that is. And then followed up by Attack on Titan on Thursday. And then whatever else. I mean, it just can't get better than that, Ronald. It's a lot of good stuff. And I just want to do like a throwback. Throwback show, Freaks and Geeks. I mean, I know James Franco's in it. And James Franco, bit of a weirdo. But we can take that aside. We can separate the art from the artist, which I can totally do. I will say, the main actress in this movie, or in this show, I forgot her name, but Linda Cardellini is literally probably, I mean, just one of the most, just like a childhood crush. Because I did, like, I wouldn't say I grew up watching the show, but I remember it being on, not a lot, but around when I was a lot younger, and she just always caught my eye, and, you know, but everybody else, Seth Rogen, like, it's a lot of their first big roles, which is really cool, and it's just gets to see all these people at a young age, all these actors, and it's really cool, and it's just, like the title says, Freaks and Geeks, motherfuckers in high school, and just there's weirdos and there's the geeks and whatever, like it's a good show, and I we could go through the whole first season, boys, go through the whole first season, and just you know, unfortunately watch the show end at 18 episodes, so this will be a fun ride. 18 weeks of freaks and geeks. Good lord, I can't talk. It's almost 3 a.m. It's 2 a.m. But yes, I got bored, and I couldn't sleep at first. I was trying to sleep, and then I couldn't fall asleep, because I feel a lot better. We're not gonna get into it, but yes, Freaks and Geeks, season 1, episode 1, only season is season 1, unfortunately. What a fantastic show it was when it came out. Just such a good time, a good era, I guess. I mean, I was born in 2001, but I mean, I grew up watching this, and like I said, I haven't finished it, but I have seen it, but it has been years, so I don't really remember how much goes, but I'm just excited, man. Let's do it. Recording in OBS in 3, 2, 1. And recording on Paramount Plus, which is what I'm watching on Paramount Plus. And we'll be starting that in 3, 2, 1.
Come on, ladies!
Excuse me, is our little practice bothering you?
Get out of here.
Whatever it is that we need to work through. But we need to communicate.
I love how it doesn't even start off with our main characters, some random football dude.
It's just that I love you so much. It scares me.
He had to come up with something.
And so I get there. And the stupid priest says,
I'm not gonna lie, younger James Franco was hot as fuck. Ah, there she is. Queen. There's the geeks. The boys. Is that Martin's, or whatever the... Oh, shit.
Bill Murray.
I forgot about this motherfucker.
I'm gonna cream you, man.
I'm gonna cream you? Martin Starr, I knew it was him. God, look at young Martin Starr, dude. What a classic intro.
It's a great intro.
She had premarital sex. You know what she did on graduation day? Died.
Died.
Heroin. Smart ones.
I'm sure there are plenty of kids who are just dying for someone to ask them.
Who's that?
John Wayne.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Why does my mom always put a note in my lunch? It's so embarrassing.
At least your mom doesn't write the note on the bag.
I love you, little man.
Hey, Daniel.
Hey, Lindsay. What's up? Where you been?
He's just eating all the shit off the plate.
Guys.
I'm sorry. Your butt was calling to me.
Hey, Nicholas.
That's so awkward. God damn.
Prior engagement. My cousin just sent me a bunch of mushrooms, and I'm going to eat them.
Based. Again?
Lindsay, what's wrong with you?
There's nothing wrong with me. I just don't want to do decathlon this year.
Well, aren't you at least going to help us sell our freshmen at the homecoming dance? We're trying to raise money to buy the school computer.
The school computer.
Carried it through the halls?
People probably saw her with it and everything.
I wonder if she has a date for the dance.
Cindy Sanders is in love with you, man.
It's good stuff. It's good stuff.
He's a cheerleader. You've seen Star Wars 27 times. Do the math.
You just said to steal the test.
Oh, good work, genius. Way to use your brain.
What?
I'm cutting. Who's got gum?
Oh, yeah. I forgot about her.
Hey, Eli. Do you want to go to homecoming dance with me?
Yes, I do. Yeah, please. Yeah, I will go.
Good. Come on, Eli.
All right, fellas.
Oh, this motherfucker. Yes.
I'm going to let you guys
play some dodgeball. The best days ever. The best days in school ever. It's like, hey, we're going to relax from all the other stuff. We're just going to play some dodgeball. And it's always the best.
Oh my God.
All right, come on, guys. Let's go.
Now, this just makes it unfun.
We just let ourselves get hit.
That's why you gotta have even teams. You gotta have some good players on one team and some good players on the other. I loved being in these 1v7 scenarios. I would clutch them sometimes, but not really that often. Oh, fuck. Uh-oh. The garrison, oh my god. See, we never used those kind of dodgeballs. And I'm kind of glad we didn't, because those look like they hurt like a motherfucker.
Not this way. There's a good kind of laughing and a bad kind of laughing. This is bad. Eli, they're only laughing at you because you're retarded.
I'm not retarded, I'm special. I'm special.
Eli, you are special. Yeah, I'm sorry. I know you're special. They're being mean to you.
I'm not retarded.
Okay.
You're retarded.
I'm sorry.
No! I'm not retarded. I'm special. I don't want to go to jail for you. No!
Sorry.
That's hard to watch, man. I totally forgot about that. That was rough. That was a little rough. Not gonna lie.
So what's going on here?
The counselor.
Is there ever a cop in this?
That's between you and your god, Bill.
It's between you and your god.
I don't think so.
I think you like me. I think you wanna kiss me.
Oh god.
That's so cringe.
Wait for me.
I remember my senior year, I was, that's when I started skipping. That was a good time. Just, I would be like, I'm not going. I don't care.
14 mounted toms. 8 floor
toms. I especially did it in college, too.
4 slashes, 2 gongs, 10 cowbells, 4 rides, 5 snares, man. A rototom rack. And it's all mounted on my infamous quadruple kick drums.
Jesus, what a drum set. Good God.
At the homecoming dance. I'll see you Saturday at 7.
You know who used to cut class? Jimi Hendrix. You know what happened to him?
Dead.
He died, choking on his own vomit.
He always has to make those stupid comparisons.
So, you do think that we could beat up Alan?
After all of that. Oh.
You want a piece of me? I'll kill you.
Bring it on.
I'll kill you.
Do you want to go to the homecoming dance with me?
Well, I'm already going with Dan Lewis. He asked me 2 weeks ago.
That's pain.
Oh, okay.
I'd say you have a pretty good life.
Exactly. It's a good line. I like that. We'll search for tomorrow. I went to one high school dance, I think. One or two, I don't remember. But, yeah, that shit's dog shit. I don't miss it. How sweet. How sweet. He's in.
That's the perfect couple. I mean, they got some chemistry. What the fuck?
So lighthearted and nice. Just makes you feel good, you know what I mean? I think he's high on those shrooms back there. It's good stuff. That's good stuff. I mean, it's such a good show. And I bring me back into it. Like I said, it's been a good long time since I've watched Freaks and Geeks, and it's just, you know, it's lighthearted, it's fun, and I enjoy it quite a bit. I mean, all the performances all around, the characters are very well done, and just in that first episode, the pilot, it lets you know about everybody in the show, who's all involved, all your characters, your big main characters, Lindsay's friend, her parents, her brother's friends, the freaks, you know, that's pretty much the stoners and the people who like, you know, rock and shit like that. Those people are freaks. They're not nice people. They are bad guys, but it's just cool. And it also, I mean, I wasn't around during the 90s, obviously, but, or the 80s, but it does bring me back to high school, like those just social aspects of high school and, you know, just whatever it may be. And I do miss certain aspects of high school, just having the freedom compared to now. I mean, I have a lot of freedom now compared, but then it was so simple, and I went to school, got off, and the rest of whatever was whatever. And the weekends were all for me. Like, it was a good time. It was a good time. I didn't have to worry about money, whatever it may be. And it's fun because you can relate to both sides of characters. Like, you know, I've been a freak before. I was a geek, and I'm like all of those meshed in, and it's just cool. And yeah, I mean, I love Linda Cardellini as Lindsay. I mean, I ever since a kid with what was it? Scooby-Doo. She played Velma. I've just been in love with her ever since. Like, she is somebody that I've just, I love her. And I can enjoy anything she's in because she's just such a beautiful soul. I'll say that. Obviously, James Franco, if you could separate the art from the artist, he does a great job. He's a great actor. And his role as Daniel in this is very good. And, you know, I like Jason Segel's character. When it comes to Jason Segel, this might be one of my favorite characters of his altogether. I really like his character. And he's very relatable, too. I mean, and then Seth Rogen's character, Ken. Obviously, you'll get more of him and more in-depth. This one was obviously the pilot, so you see a little bit of him. But he's that stoner, kind of asshole, sarcastic guy. But he also has a heart. And then Sam, you know. Sam's a great character. Neil, his buddy, and then Martin Starr's Bill. I mean, it's fun. It's fun. You got a lot of good characters. Then you have Kim. That actress, she was in something a long time ago, but I don't remember what it was. It might have been, yeah, White Chicks. But I don't know. I just love the cast of the show, and I just love how just the show is. It's such a good show and relatable, lighthearted, funny, sad. Great just performances all around at certain points when it does get serious. So I just can't wait to watch all of this. It's sad that, you know, it only had a season, and it really is just one of the best shows there. Like one of those shows that it's just sad you got to see taken away so early, like this, Firefly, and some other shows out there, obviously. But yeah, man, I mean, this is a great one. I do want to start getting into like classic shows like that I've seen, but I haven't watched in a while. So like this is one of those because I haven't watched this in a while, but I have watched it. I also do want to do a Boy Meets World reaction series at some point in time, because as a kid, every morning before school, I would watch Boy Meets World every single morning. And it was great. It was fantastic. I missed that. But I never watched it in full order. It would always jump between episodes. Like, I would be like, oh my god, look at these. They're kids now. And then just like a day later, 2 days later, it's like, oh, they're adults now. Or they're not adults, but they're a lot older. And I'm like, oh, what happened in between all that? But so that would be fun to get into. Just like some classic show reactions. That would be fun. But yeah, man. Freaks and Geeks. Great first episode. And I just can't wait to get into the rest of the episodes with y'all. We're just having fun with this. We're not really here to break down anything, maybe here in this first episode at least. But there might be some stuff to break down later on when it comes to deeper meanings between things and whatever it may be. But this truly is one of my favorite shows. Obviously, like I said, I haven't watched it in a long time. But it's fun to jump back into it and watch it with a new perspective, because it's been some time since I've watched it. That first episode was great. Like I said, I love Linda Carnalini as Lindsay. She's just perfect. So yeah, hope you guys enjoyed. I don't know what day I'm going to upload this on. This might be a Wednesday upload or a Thursday upload, maybe even a Friday. I don't know what we're going to do yet. So when you do see this, I'm recording it on Monday, but I don't know if this is going to come out Wednesday, Thursday, or Friday. My schedule for videos, because Wednesday we're going to have 2 videos. So if you see this on Wednesday, you're going to have 3 videos altogether. If you see this on Thursday, you'll have 2. If you see this on Friday, you'll have 2 as well, maybe. We'll see. We'll see how it is. But I hope you guys enjoyed my reaction. Can't wait to get into more of it. Make sure to like, subscribe, comment. Let me know what you think about the show and the first episode, my reaction. What are your thoughts? If you love the show and if you ever watched it growing up, click the notification bell. Follow me on Twitch, Twitter, wherever it may be. And it's been good, guys.